Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Most Holy Redeemer. It's good to have you all here on this Holy Thursday night. I don't have any announcements for you other than I hope you join us tomorrow for Good Friday at 7 p.m. and at the vigil on Saturday at 8 p.m. or on our Easter Sunday Masses at 8 a.m. or 10 a.m. Do we have any visitors, any returning parishioners that we can welcome? Hi, good to have you. Well, let's all stand and greet one another as we begin our celebration.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, as we enter into these three sacred days, the Holy Triduum, we begin, of course, with the sign of the cross. Nothing unusual about that, but I mention it tonight, and we might take note of it because we won't sign ourselves again in our liturgies until Easter Vigil on Saturday night. The Triduum, the 3 days, it is of one piece, really a liturgical season unto itself. It begins tonight, carries us through to Good Friday, and on to the great Easter Vigil. So my friends, as we truly enter into these 3 days, we allow our every thought, our word, our action, our deed to be kind of wrapped in an awareness of the Paschal mystery, that is the death and resurrection of Jesus. The Triduum is moving, it is deeply enriching, with the days and the liturgies blending into one solemn and sacred moment. We step out of Chronos, the time we all are kind of bound to, and we step into Kairos, God's time. We join in fully as we enter into these three holy days. And so we begin, my friends, In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of the Lord, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Yes, my friends, we enter into this sacred and holy time.
Several days ago, united with the priests and faithful of the Archdiocese of San Francisco, Archbishop Cardiglione consecrated the Holy Chrism and blessed the oils for use in the anointing of the sick and in preparation of catechumens for baptism. Tonight, we receive these holy oils for use in celebration of the Church's sacraments during the coming year. Catechumens. Sacred Chrism. Thank you.
God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son went about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church, a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th day of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14 days of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat it like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For in the same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment in all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I'll pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. precious indeed in your sight, the life and death of those you love. We are your servants, for you have set us free. Our blessing now.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. So before the feast of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have their feet washed, for they are clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that, as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Tonight, we begin our celebration of Easter. It is one feast with three parts. It is like looking at it from in a prism. It's all the same, just different parts. In the early nomads were on their way and they were in a hurry. So they had to have unleavened bread because they didn't have time to have the yeast rise. So tonight we are going to have unleavened bread as our participation in our Christian Passover. We have no permanent dwelling place. This earth is not our home. We are waiting, we are preparing our whole lives for our final dwelling place with God. One thing that is really important, and we have heard it in our music tonight, we've heard it in our readings, that we celebrate as a community. We do not celebrate alone. This is not a God and I experience. This gathered community is celebrating. The Israelites, as it was in the first reading, had said that the blood of the lamb was sacrificed and the blood was put on the lintels of the doorsteps to mark the chosen people, and God would pass over, he would not destroy them. And so we consume the blood of Christ when we receive communion in the form of wine. And we receive communion in the form of bread as our celebration. At the Last Supper, Jesus modeled for the disciples how they were to act and how we should live. He took off his garments and he began to wash feet. Now, you know this, that in early times they walked the desert and their feet were very dirty. And it was a sign of hospitality when you entered a room to have the slave wash your feet so that you could be clean when you got to the person's house. How would you feel if your boss at work were to wash your feet? You might be pretty shocked, like, this can't happen. This is not how it's supposed to be. So you could imagine how shocked the disciples were when Jesus removed his garment and began to wash their feet. Somehow, feet are very important to us. We walked a long way in these feet, but they're very personal. Some places, I know some sisters who are elderly and they can't wash feet, so they wash hands. But somehow it's not the same. Somehow our feet reflect a vulnerability that we have. Several years ago, it was my job to call 12 people to ask them if they would have their feet washed. And each conversation was pretty much the same. My feet? You can't wash my feet. Oh, my feet are terrible. I have bunions. They're just awful. You can't wash my feet. And the conversation would end in hysterical laughing. And we would laugh and laugh because they were just, the story of their feet was just unbelievable. But that's not what it's about. It's, we are vulnerable. We come up. And it's about losing ourselves. It's about being humble. And somehow washing feet puts us in that place of vulnerability, and our whole self is there. And we are bonded with the person who is washing our feet. There's a camaraderie there. We are the body of Christ. It's not about little old me. It's about us putting forth ourselves, that we can learn the lesson. Jesus told the disciples, you do not understand what I am doing, but you will. And it is a life lesson. And why do we wash feet and break bread in the same liturgy? They complement each other. Jesus wanted us to share in his experience. The night before he died, he was selfless. He came here on this earth not to die. He came here to tell us how to love, and the cost of love is selflessness. And he died on the cross because he loved so much. And the lesson for us is to learn how to give of ourselves, to embody the message. We break bread and we share it as a community. The song that we sang tonight, our blessing cup, we share it. It's all about not being an individual, but being this community. We were baptized into Christ's death and Christ's resurrection. We are called to become what we receive. That's what St. Augustine said many, many years ago. So what does that mean? It means that we enter into God's time, and we are part of that Last Supper. And we give witness to the message of sharing in Christ's death and resurrection. Our task is to go out and spread the good news by our witnessing. We are not called to keep this gift to ourselves. We are called to spend ourselves with our brothers and sisters. And when we ask ourselves, who are our brothers and sisters? It is to whom we meet, all the people that come our way. We are called to love them no matter who they are, no matter what they look like, where they are. We are the body of Christ. So we are to die to ourselves. We are to enter into this mystery of breaking bread, of being called to give witness, and to enter into the mystery to which God has invited us. We are one body, one bread, one community in Christ.
Sister Marilyn, thank you. Sister Marilyn and Ron had a huge part in this liturgy this night, but someone had a very significant part. How many of you remember Carlos Rodriguez, the world's oldest altar boy? I think a lot of us remember Carlos. So Carlos died exactly 1 year ago today, just a few days shy of his 90th birthday. Carlos gave his life in service and in ministry to the church. He said one of the greatest privileges in his life was to serve on the altar, to be an altar, and the world's oldest altar boy, to be an acolyte, an altar server faithfully. He opened those church doors 7 days a week, so many years. I think he told me he served at least a dozen priests over the decades. And he said it was the greatest honor of his life. So as you're washing feet or having your feet washed, notice the beautiful pictures and the bowls. They were hand thrown for us, and the gift from Carlos' estate allowed us to have these beautiful works of art created for this liturgy. Now Jesus says it so well. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. So my friends, we are all invited. We are all invited to serve and to be served. I think the greater challenge is that, to accept the challenge to allow ourselves to be washed, to humble ourselves, to expose our bunions and our whatever blisters and our not always pretty feet, to just humbly let ourselves be loved. So yes, we are all invited to come forward, to have our feet washed, and then in turn, to wash the next person's feet behind you, if you are able. And so we begin. Thank you. And so my friends, the humble act of washing feet and allowing someone to wash our feet, it reminds us that we all have a share in Christ's ministry, a share in Christ's wondrous, abundant, and inclusive love. And so on this night, we are mindful of the many ways that, yes, we have been served, the many ways that we are called to serve, the many ways that we have been blessed, and the many ways that we are called to go forward and be blessed. Remembering Jesus' selfless love for us, let us continue to serve him, to love him with our prayer.
For our church leaders, may they model what it means to be a servant church, serving those most in need. We pray to the Lord. For the medical workers, journalists, photographers, and all who serve those trying to survive in Gaza, Ukraine, and Haiti, we pray to the Lord. The members of our community, that we may respond to the invitation to deepen our awareness of what the Eucharist is and what it demands from us. We pray to the Lord. For those preparing to receive the sacrament of baptism at the Easter Vigil, and those who will receive the sacraments at Easter, we pray to the Lord. For all who are ill, in pain, or experiencing physical or emotional distress, may they find relief in God's healing powers. We pray to the Lord. For those who have gone before us in faith, especially Susan Ryan, may they celebrate at the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious and loving God, your beloved Son Jesus demonstrates for us the way of perfect humility. Give us the strength we need to be like him in all that we do, washing the feet of both friend and foe. May these sacred days draw us into the mystery of his suffering, death, and resurrection. Hear these prayers we speak aloud. Hear the prayers we hold in our hearts. We offer them all through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord and Savior. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, and so that it might become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks. Thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, O Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Salvador, our Bishop, all the clergy, the religious, with your entire people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. In this Mass, we remember Trudy's beloved one, Reginald Miller. We remember Tessa's beloved one, Benedicto Deza. We remember all of our beloved ones, all of those who've gone before us, marked with a sign of love. All those who have died in God's mercy, welcome them, O Lord, into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Friends, it is at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, that we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. My friends, let us share with each other some sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
My friends, behold the Lamb of God, bread broken, wine poured out, given for us to nourish us that we may give. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grants, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity. Who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. So one brief announcement. So in just a few moments, we'll take the Blessed Sacrament and we place it in the altar of repose. You may notice this is the one 24-hour period, 40, maybe a little longer, that the tabernacle is empty, the sanctuary light is not burning, the tomb is empty in a sense. And we pause, we give thanks for this bread from heaven, and we hear the challenge to go out and be bread. Be bread for a world that hungers. So we process, very simple procession, right back to the prayer chapel in the back of the church. The church remains open until 10 o'clock tonight. You're welcome to linger, to pray, to just take quiet moments. And so we do not conclude with final blessing. We do not conclude with the sign of the cross. We simply take Jesus to his place of rest.